Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to talk about circuit breakers. We're here in the Fenix A320 mod, flight simulator, and let's take a look at the breakers themselves. So the Airbus well decorated with breakers. So we've got the overhead panel breakers up here, and our rear wall panel here, which is sometimes you'll find obscured by the jump seat. Generally we got sort of lower amperage breakers here, and we have hiding down here behind the first officer's seat higher amperage breakers. So we got sort of 50 amps, you can see the numbers on the front there, 20 and 50s here. So galley and electric hydraulic pumps, for example, are located there. So familiarize yourself with those. The galley breakers are actually something that fail the most, and that's due to the ovens and the hot water heaters, the tea and coffee making facilities, unfortunately. So it's always a bad day when one of those goes. But yeah, that's where they are. So you see the numbers on the front depicting the amps, the amp rating. When we come into the cockpit, we will have a look at the breakers themselves, make sure they're not popped. And we usually, the best place to see that is to come along the side here and look down at the line, and you can see if anything's popped out. When they are popped out, you will see a white collar on. See that white bar there? That's a helpful indicator, but difficult to see sometimes when they're tucked behind one another. So and more difficult to see up here as well when you're standing underneath. So sort of run your fingers along a bit, looking, trying to feel for a bump. That's how we try and locate the pop breakers. So we have two different types of breakers on the Airbus 320. We have monitored, which are the green breakers. So when one of these breakers is out for more than a minute, a circuit breaker trip warning is triggered on the ECAM. The black circuit breakers are not monitored, so we'll not get an ECAM alert for a black breaker being out. So we can have a look at one of those. So we got the wheel page. We can take the PSI system out by popping the tire pressure indicator here. So that's that row M, and there you go. The values have disappeared there, and we won't get an ECAM for that. We were just by chance noticed that our PSI is missing, and we're scrambling around for a breaker at some point as part of our checks. So put that back in. Those readings come back. Now, if we pop a green breaker, so it's brake fans there, we should get an ECAM for that around about 60 seconds time. And that will give us an approximate location. So it usually gives you a range in terms of letters to look at, or it will say overhead panel to identify that. We have got these breakers here with red collars on the wingtip brakes. There to stop us resetting those if they pop, so we don't end up with flight controls in an abnormal position. So we can't reset those in flight. And something else you'll see in terms of, you know, there's something that's not a minimum equipment list item that's popped and, you know, it's been taken out of use. You'll see a white collar wire tied in behind these when they're popped, and that's put in by maintenance to stop us resetting those. Not modeled here, but something you do see when flying the line. So let's take a look, see if we're going to get that notification up for our pop breaker there. That should come up shortly. There we go. We've got circuit breaker tripped, rear panel between rows J and M. And we've got J at the bottom, M at the top. And this one is indeed on row L. Now, we could just push that back in, and if everything was okay, no further faults, the ECAM caution would go away. If we have repeated pops becoming a nuisance, and that breaker wasn't, you know, resetting, something we can do is push the emergency cancel button on that. And that creates a message here at the bottom that caution is cancelled. And when that's pressed, it inhibits the ECAM circuit brake, trip caution for the remainder of the flight, but only for that locality between J and M. So other, if we popped a circuit breaker, for example, on the overhead now, that would still come through. So we can do one of those up here. It'll come through after a minute. But if we were to pop the other brake fan circuit breaker, we wouldn't get a caution for that. Now, there is another way of dealing with these. And we could just clear. We could press this clear button here on the... we get that ECAM message. But if the circuit breaker remains pulled, i.e. you know, it's popped, any additional circuit breakers on that same panel will not be detected and the ECAM will not trigger the caution. However, the circuit breakers push back in, any additional trip circuit breakers will be detected and the ECAM will trigger the caution again. There's a slight danger with just clearing out that ECAM message with a pop breaker, is that it's going to silence the alerts for the rest of the panel and we haven't got a message for that either. So that's, I would prefer to use the emergency cancel button for that. We should get the ECAM alert for that monitored breaker on the overhead shortly. There it is. So if I was to clear that one, for example, we'd obviously put master caution. But yep, clear that one. Discarded. If another breaker was then to pop on this panel up here, we would not be notified of that. However, if this was reset and another breaker was pulled, we should be notified of that. But that's one of the catches of using the clear button on that message. I prefer to have that emergency cancel button used, so you've got that reminder there that you have got the alerts muted, if you like, in that area of the aircraft, and it just reminds you to keep an eye on what's going on there. So yep, sometimes we do get nuisance alerts, well, not nuisance, things continue popping for some reason. They can't be reset, and we don't want to have to obviously continually be pushing that breaker in and resetting the ECAM cautions. So, yeah, two different ways of dealing with that. They don't reset. We can emergency cancel button on those or clear. Yeah, using clear, you need to make sure if that circuit breaker remains out, you're not going to get cautions for the rest of that particular panel. There we go. So we have pushed the other breaker in after clearing it, and we have got that message back for the other breaker. So it just shows that that does work, but only if that breaker is reset. And we could now, let's say this was another nuisance one, we could emergency cancel on that one as well. So it builds a list up of what is being muted down here, basically. So now the overhead panel and those particular rows there are now muted because we're getting continual alerts, which we can't reset the breakers on. So that's how we deal with those. And it's important to know, you know, approximately where some of these systems are. Usually the more important bits are within reach, closest to the pilots here on the overhead. But yeah, just bear in mind, you've got the higher voltage, higher amperage breakers down behind the first officer. But yeah, they are obviously marked out using the letter and number system. A bit of a grid reference, so you can find those easily. So that's circuit breakers. You can play around with these and generate some interesting sort of failure scenarios. I know we have the failure system within the EFB, but I haven't been all the way through that. I don't know if you can take out, you know, the same things within that as you can here with the circuit breakers, but you can create some scenarios. It is common to have circuit breakers pop in the real world, so you know, we will have certain items out on any particular flight quite often. I hope you found that interesting. Any questions on that, drop them in chat. Please like and subscribe, and look out for future content. Thanks for watching.